That's the spirit of rural Utah coming right at you on At Your Leisure.
It's the county fair to end all county fairs today as Chad and I experience 100 years of history and fun at one destination that has a lot to offer.
We'll take you from top to bottom and show you not only why events like this are so special, but why this particular one is making history. All that, and we'll sample the food.
At Your Leisure's next in a 56 Mercury.
When you're in, you're absolutely eating this up. Hi, everybody. Welcome to At Your Leisure this week. I'm Chad Booth.
And I'm Rhea Rossi Booth. And we are at the Duchesne County Fair in Duchesne, Utah. And they're celebrating their centennial this year. So they've pulled out all the stops, and it is nothing but fun here.
That's right. We're actually in the parade. It's part of the last day of the festivities. It's county fair time in Utah. And if you've never been to a county fair, you don't know what you're missing. See what I mean? If you have never been to a county fair, you don't know what you're missing, but you are about to find out.
This is a little bit more special than most of them. We always have some pretty good fairs. This one, we've added a lot to it because it's our 100th year as being a county, Duchesne County. And so the centennial celebration is added to it. It just brings everybody together and renews old acquaintances and friendships. Governor Herbert was out, Congressman Rob Bishop was out. There's something here for everybody. You know, a lot of people love the rodeos, other people love the stock shows. And so they're just, you know, you just come in and it is, it's just a fun time for everybody.
Crowds have been very big. We had Neil McCoy on Wednesday play for us, put on a phenomenal show. We're wrapping up today with a car show. Horse poles, Indian dances, rodeo. Charlie Jenkins is playing today. It's just been a phenomenal week and wrapping it all up tonight. What it does is brings us together as a community, not just to a city, but as a county. The 4-H and all the kids doing their animals brings huge crowds, and they've sold a lot of livestock. The funds go back to the kids to help promote them and brings the new generation into the farming and ranching that is critical to our area, as well as the oil and gas. Definitely come out to look for anything that you want to do in the outdoors.
There's places to go and hike. There's places to go and ride ATVs, four-wheelers, whatever you want to go do. You can camp up here to starvation. You can fish, you can boat. We have King's Peak, it's in our county. And you can go up there to that. There's just something for everyone to come out here and do.
This says everything about a county fair. Oliver Wendell Douglas in his Green Acres tractor, the local Farm Bureau. I love the spirit of rural America.
It's beautiful. We're gonna go to our travel adventure with Steve Heumann. And it's not about the quantity, it's about the quality of horsepower. Watch this.
Thanks guys, I'm Stephen Heumann, and my travel adventure is a little bit different than what you guys are experiencing today. I'm going on horseback, old cowboy style. I'm right outside of Parowan, Utah, and this is a trip you're gonna want to experience. Let's go, boss.
When you're riding on a horse, you can actually just relax and you can take the country in, and you're not having to worry about stumbling over a rock if you're hiking or if you're riding a bike. You know, a lot of times folks wreck because they look at something that's kind of pretty. Well, the horses are really, really sure-footed. Anytime you can get on the back of a four-legged animal that's a real good, trustworthy animal that's been trained properly, it's just absolutely stunning, you know, the beauty of it.
For Mike Thornton, that beauty is something he experiences every morning. As a lifelong cowboy, Mike has spent his days in the saddle, running sheep, chasing cattle, and riding into the veiled beauty of Parowan Canyon. Today he shares that lifestyle with visitors from around the world as he runs Winter Hawk trail rides with his wife Jamie through the red rocks and pine forests between the small town of Parowan and the ski slopes of Bryanhead. This is his ancestral home, one he knows all too well.
My uncle Scott L. Orton, he was actually up on the mountain with his herd of sheep. He said, you know, Mike, he said, this canyon is dry as a bone. He said, the only thing it's good for is to look at. He said, someday you need to bring people up here and show them this. And that's all we do today.
We started calling it Mike's National Park. So it's beautiful. It's kind of like a mini Grand Canyon. Kind of when you're going down the trail and you're riding your horse, sometimes you get the feeling there should be Indians with bows and arrows up on those rocks. And you got to be careful out there riding.
I found Mike and Jamie ready beside the road at the entrance to Parowan Canyon, about 20 minutes north of Cedar City on I-15. Their proud horses and access to rugged terrain seemed like the perfect way to enjoy this lesser traveled area.
We're here every day unless we're at Horse Valley. Sometimes we'll go to Brian Head. So we're kind of like a mobile horse trail riding business.
From Horse Valley Peak, you can see Bryce Canyon. You can look back towards Brian Head. And then you can also see all the beautiful red rock country that we're in right now down here in Parowan Canyon. And then clear out into Nevada. It's absolutely beautiful.
The views are striking, but it was the experience itself that captured my imagination today. The quiet of the hooves as we moved through the brush. The feel of being a part of the world in a new but also incredibly ancient way. We all have dreams of being cowboys and riding out on adventures, and that's what this journey was really all about for me. Discovering foundations of old trading posts, crossing streams, and listening to Mike's stories of life on the range. Winterhawk Trail Rides offers several different tours, including 1 to 3 hour trips, full day treks and overnighters, even wagon rides through the backcountry. All of them are meant to remind visitors of a lifestyle we've all come to romanticize, but that still survives in hardy trailblazers like Mike and Jamie.
On each ride, we take pictures, and then I also will sing a song or two to the folks if they'd like. And I always give them the opportunity if they want to get off their horse and get a rock and hit me with the rock if they don't like the song, that's the option that they have. Through these pine-studded Utah hills makes me believe in the power of God. You know, from the time I was just a little boy, all the old-timers used to tell me that we lived in God's country. And we really do. We live in God's country out here, and I hope all of you can someday come out and see it, and we'd be glad to help you to see it on the back of a horse or in our wagon.
Well, you can find out more about Winterhawk Trail Rides at winterhawktrailrides.com. It's just that simple. We need to take a commercial break. When we come back, we'll have this week's product review, and I bet it'll have more horsepower, unfortunately, than Boston.
This is an all-new upgraded experience for first-time buyers on a budget. With big towing power, room for three, and sporty good looks. Yamaha's all-new V1 series is packed with features and amenities not found on competing entry-level watercraft. A reliable Yamaha marine engine, roomy three-up riding, built-in storage, a stable, fun hull design, and a fit and finish that looks like it costs a whole lot more.
There are certain types of people out there who put everything to the test. For them, we built the Can-Am Maverick XDS with the first factory-installed turbo. It delivers 121 horsepower, impressive suspension travel, and exclusive Fox shocks. It's engineered to ace any test, including yours. Can-Am, the ride says it all.
Tucked away just outside of Cedar City, Utah, are two of Southern Utah's best-kept secrets, Canaraville Falls and Kolob Canyons. The rare scenic views create beautiful backdrops to capture the perfect selfie. Get your selfie to Canaraville Falls or Kolob Canyons and get in on one of Utah's best-kept secrets. Go to visitcedarcity.com and access your adventure.
Well, welcome back to At Your Leisure. I'm Darren Kinder, and as usual, I'm out messing around on an ATV. And today we've got the new Arctic Cat XR500. Come on, let me show you how much fun it is.
There's a couple things I'd really like to point out on this machine. One is, it's going downhill. Even on one of the steeper hills, I had to give it a little bit of gas. It holds back so well. And we went up one of the really steep hills, and it had such great traction and such good power, I was more worried about flipping it over than I was at making it to the top.
This new 500 from Arctic Cat has really stepped up their game. The fit and finish on this machine is vastly improved. The way it shifts in and out of gear is super smooth. The digital display, and even look at the finish on this rack and stuff. Everything has really been brought up a notch. It also has a two-wheel drive, four-wheel drive switch over here, which is really easy to operate, and then also I'll lock in the front end on it. Now, one of the things that I'd like to point out too on this machine is that right here, there's a braided brake line on this. It's not a plastic line, it's a steel braided line, which, you know, is never gonna fail on you. You ride this thing for 100 years and that thing will still be intact. The machine also has a reverse override button on it, which allows you to be able to press that when you're backing up. You know, if you're plowing, stuff like that, allows you to back up at full speed. Now take a look under this seat. It's really accessible, it just pops right off, and you've got your air cleaner right here. There's a little cover to go over your battery, which is really easy to get to, and also a toolkit. Now up here in the front, we have a double A arm front suspension, disc brakes, all of that kind of stuff. Kind of cool little push bars on it, and of course it's a winch ready system. But one of the things I'd really like to point out is look how easy it is to get to the oil filter on this machine. I mean, anybody can reach in there, change their oil themselves, because that filter just spins right off. Now, even though this 500 is kind of like their base machine, because you know you have the steel wheels on it and whatnot, but notice they didn't put a McPherson strut on this. They went with a full double A arm, coilover shock and everything on that. So the ride and handling is much better on this. The same thing in the rear, you've got the double A arm with the coilover. You get a full 11 inches of clearance on it. And this machine rides quite well. I definitely think that Arctic Cat has stepped up their game a little bit on this machine. The fit and finish is much better on it, and it really is a clean machine to take out and ride and enjoy the day with. Well, if you need to check one of these out, get into Jorgensen down in Richfield or any one of the Arctic Cat dealers, and they'll be glad to show you this new model. Well, I'm Darren Kinder. We'll see you next time.
It's all new from the ground up. New rack system, new LED headlights and taillights, new chassis, and new improved ergonomics. Introducing the all-new Arctic Cat ATVs. Filthy, clean, fun.
Doesn't matter what type of adventure you're searching for, at Utah State Parks, you'll find it. History comes alive in the oldest government building in Utah, the Territorial Statehouse State Museum in Fillmore. This week's featured Utah State Park. Brigham Young originally commissioned this structure as Utah's Capitol building, but when the seat of government returned to Salt Lake, the Territorial Statehouse became the premier historic location for our pioneer artifacts. Two restored pioneer cabins and an 1867 stone schoolhouse are also located on the grounds. Camping and lodging facilities are located nearby, and with a day use fee of only $2, this is one of the hidden gems of our state park system. The museum is easy to find right on Highway 99 in downtown Fillmore. Utah State Parks, adventures for everyone.
America's most innovative off-road vehicles are all on sale during the Polaris factory authorized clearance. Get our biggest rebate ever on Razor XP 1000. Save $1,000 on remaining 2015s while they last. Get our lowest price ever on Ace 4x4. This all-new off-road experience is just $64.99 after rebate. Get the year's best deals during the Polaris factory authorized clearance.
Welcome back to At Your Leisure, everybody. We're at the Duchesne County Centennial Fair. and I have never had this much fun. I think even when I was a kid.
Well, that's because this is a once in 100 year fair. It's their centennial, that's why.
It is, and you're the big kid too now that I'm with you.
That's true. So Rhea, let me ask you a question. What is your favorite part of the fair? Is it the bunnies, or the goats, the cows? Is
the parade?
The parade?
Or love the parade.
Or is it the food, the rides? What is it?
It's everything. It's absolutely everything. It's the food, it's the rides, it's the parade, it's the people, it's the adorable little kids running around having fun.
Okay, so like let's ride right here?
Yeah.
Well, let's do it.
No.
Come on.
No.
You said you like the rides. Come on.
Woo! Okay,
only
that's
two.
Stop.
Only
that's
two.
Only two.
Champion.
No, don't go backwards.
This is my vintage right here. If I'm not mistaken, this is probably a 54 Dodge.
Look at this Route 66. Don't you just want to go back in time?
My second car was a 1967 Ford Galaxy convertible.
I'm asking him if I can have a ride. I'm begging. He has no idea what trouble he's going to be getting into right now.
Anybody who works with me at the office knows that I'm constantly landing on my head. Yeah!
Family, friends, good people, and just rural America. You can't beat it. So all this stuff is handmade from all the people in the county. Absolutely beautiful. Look over here, which I think is incredible. Best in show. This is handmade. I'm thinking I want that right there, Chad. I want that big, fluffy dog.
Okay, Rhea, see if you can outdo me.
Oh, really?
You're out, Rhea.
That was fun. Well, no county fair experience would be complete without this jumbo hand-dipped corn dog. Yep, it's all mine, baby.
Navajo taco. If you're in Duchesne County, you've got to have a Navajo taco. You can get this with meat, or you can get it with dessert like I did. It's got sugar and cinnamon on it.
And our Coke that has cherry flavoring in it, which is delicious.
Okay, I took a taste of that. Where did you get that? That is not like cherry Coke. That's like homebrew. What is that?
It's so good. And this is where I got that wonderful little corn dog up at Grandma's Minis. They are awesome. You talk, they got the fried food thing down. Sorry you're not here to enjoy it with us.
Yeah, so notice that we got enough for all of you, but we're not sharing it. So while we stuff ourselves, time to go to our trailhead adventure. Now, when we're done eating all this food, we won't be able to sit down. We'll have to stand up in the car. But right now, thanks to this story brought to you by Rocky Mountain ATV, we are going to be able to show you how you can stand up on the water.
The spray of water, the scent of sand, the feel of warm air, the thrill of learning a new sport despite the fumbles and falls. You know, pretty much any day at the lake will have at least three of those four, but today, it's the last one that's the most important. Here at Pineview Reservoir in northern Utah, one event is inviting everyone to try something new on the water. It mixes novice with pro for a chance to learn and progress, all with a bit of competition thrown in.
What we have today is about 50 people that are demoing eight of the best wake surf boats out on the market from Mastercraft and Taiga and Supra and Moomba and Centurion and Nautique today, along with boards from a number of different manufacturers, including Liquid Force. And then tomorrow, it's actually in its sixth year, it's the sixth annual Wake Up Wakeboard Competition. So it's actually one of the biggest wakeboard competitions in the Western U.S. We'll see about 3,000 or 4,000 people on the shoreline and 50 of some of the best riders from Grom on up through Outlaw level, which culminates in a double up competition.
We thought we'd keep it a local event, which actually has grown, like Tony said, to pretty much a Western U.S. market.
The competition extends beyond just wakeboard stunts, though. Many visitors at the demo day have never tried any of the boats out on the water, a fact of which the dealers and manufacturers want to take advantage.
We really like to get head-to-head on the water. I mean, sitting in a showroom is one thing, but actually getting customers out on the water to experience the surf waves, to experience the boats, that's what it's all about, is having fun on the water, getting families out, friends out, and just enjoying the boats.
just good family fun. You can do multiple sports. You can surf, wakeboard, ski, tube, kneeboard, pretty much anything behind them.
The real focus of the event is the introduction day, where first-time riders get the chance to try to stand up, if even for just a moment. That fleeting thrill could potentially change the way they recreate for the rest of their lives, eventually bringing loved ones and friends along with them. It's that exponential impact that event organizers have personally experienced and why they want to share it as well.
These aren't the biggest sports in the world, and when you talk about doing it behind a boat, it absolutely has some cost to it. We're grateful to see more and more cable parks coming into the equation, which is makes it much more accessible. But we want to continue to build events like this and like the demo events where, you know, the dealerships and the manufacturers get involved to kind of introduce the sport to new people.
And those new people extend to women, who are often left out of extreme sports, which are pretty much dominated by men. Today is also about them, with gear made specifically to get women out on the water.
She Shreds is a brand and an online store for females of all ages who wakeboard, skateboard, snowboard, mountain bike. We were at the competition last year and there was such an amazing turnout. There were so many little girls here and a lot of females, and it was just a great atmosphere. It's usually mainly guys that are out there doing these sports, and a lot of girls that are involved in these action sports, they're always riding with guys, their brothers, their friends, their boyfriends, and we just wanted to build a community, a shred network, if you will, of women all over the world who are into these sports and can connect and ride together.
And that's what events like this are all about. Introducing everyone, no matter their age, ability, or gender, to a lifestyle that brings families, friends, and even first-time acquaintances together on the water. The success isn't in how large the crowds are or how skilled the riders are, but in every first attempt to stand up on the roiling wake of a tournament boat.
We had a few people let go of the rope the first time today. That's the best feeling, when you find that pocket and you learn how to actually surf the wave without a rope holding you.
When we have younger ones, especially younger boys and girls that kind of come into it, and you see them practically apply things that you've kind of taught them, that it builds character, it builds confidence, it just makes them, you know, broader-based humans. And that's sort of the big thing for me that I walk away with, is when I see the kids like starting to blow up and, you know, lights going on, and they're throwing things in contests that work, you know.
Similar events are still being held throughout the remainder of the summer, and you can contact your local boat dealers to learn details. So if you're looking to find out what it feels like to stand on the water, your chance is just a rope tug away. From the trailhead, I'm Terry Wood.
State of Utah School and Institutional Trust Lands Administration. CITLA manages 3.5 million acres of Utah lands with the express purpose of furthering the education of Utah students while promoting local industry, oil and gas, even residential development, all at the same time. Through the careful use of trust lands, we distributed more than $22 million to Utah schools last year. The State of Utah School and Institutional Trust Lands Administration, building the state's permanent school fund.
Back in 1946, the business started as a used car operation. We took on the RV business and we've enjoyed the trailer business so much. Our goal is to make as many people happy as possible. I enjoy when they come in and they let me know they're happy. And if they're not happy, I want to make them happy. I'm excited about it. I think we have a lot of inventory out there to show people. We got some great employees. But I want to sell them on what we're here for, and it's all about service.
America's most innovative off-road vehicles are all on sale during the Polaris Factory Authorized Clearance. Get our biggest rebate ever on Razor XP 1000. Save $1,000 on remaining 2015s while they last. Get our lowest price ever on Ace 4x4. This all-new off-road experience is just $64.99 after rebate. Get the year's best deals during the Polaris factory authorized clearance.
People might tell you it's 300 miles out here, but remember, it's really only 30 miles back.
Welcome back to At Your Leisure. Today, this may look like a bridge to nowhere, but it was a bridge to prosperity in its origin.
So this bridge, it was somewhere else, and then they moved it over here.
Yes, this is called the Bridgeland Bridge. It was constructed in the 1920s by the Utah Highway Department. Their goal was to connect the communities out by Arcadia with the only U.S. highway that ran across Utah at the time, U.S. 40. Now, when they built the bridge, the communities that all of a sudden didn't have to ford the river to make their connection to civilization were so impressed, all the towns together said, let's all make one town and we'll call ourselves Bridgeland in honor of the bridge. Isn't that cool?
I think that is the best story. Only in a small town can that happen.
That's true. Now, instead of tearing it down, they decided to move it over here to the fairgrounds. They just did this year, and now it's the bridge to the parking lot.
And to the Centennial Event Center.
That's right. Connects the two together.
Very nice.
All right, what's on our agenda right now, Mizzy?
All right, well, now we're going to go to our AYL sticker winner, and her name is Chris Hale. And she is from Arizona. That's
wow.
Right, Arizona. And she gets a Camp Chef stove. So congratulations, Crystal. Give us a call at 801-947-8888 and get that Camp Chef stove in your backyard.
All right, spinning 90 degrees to the right and across the bridge, you will find our calendar of events right there. And what's coming up, make note of this, August 22nd. Is the Ride for Life. Now this is a ride, an ATV ride, that you can only do legally once a year on this ride. Starts in Tooele, and you ride all the way to Wendover. And the most fun part of it is when you get out on the salt flats, because you get to open it wide up and see how fast your ATV will go.
So why do they call it Ride for Life?
Well, because every year they give it to a health charity. This year it's the Make-A-Wish Foundation.
Oh.
And so, you know, they'll pick a charity for the year, their honored charity, and they'll go out and they'll ride to raise money. What a fun way to do it.
Beautiful way to go.
Uh-huh.
All right, well, let's take a look at next week's show.
How do Utah State Parks and OHV Adventure go together? Well, next week, Chad and Rhea are finding out as they set off from the parking lot and find sites that will make you want to hit the trail. They'll tell you where to go. Then come with me, Stephen Heumann, as I find out firsthand that sometimes you don't have to travel far from home to experience the perfect family adventure. Own the outdoors next week on AYL.
Well, that's all the time we have for At Your Leisure. Charlie Jenkins is the band. He's playing right now. At the end of this, special message from the governor. He was out here at the beginning of the fair in person. That's how big a deal this was.
I know. This is 100 years.
That's right. Now, Duchesne County Fair will be back next year. It may not be the centennial, but it'll be every bit as kicking.
Well, it looks like after this ballot, they're going to do some line dancing, so I say we head on out there.
All right. I'm in. So it's the end of our show. Our challenge to you is that you need to get out here and create your own adventures at your leisure. We'll see you next week. All right. What's on our agenda right now, Mizzy?
I don't know. I don't know anything about calendar events.
Where do you find ponies in somebody's front yard?
It's like little puppies. Warm them up.
Hey guys, if you like that video, you're going to want to watch all of our other AYL videos. You're going to want to like it, you're going to want to share it, and you're going to want to subscribe, right? See all the buttons right here? This is what you're going to want to do,
click,
right?
Click
on them, because we have some really cool videos, all kinds of behind the scenes stuff, bloopers of Alicia crashing and stuff.
Why are you going to sell me out like that, Steven?
So you want to click all of these things and subscribe to our channel, because At Your Leisure is awesome, and we'll see you here for more videos.